Hi everyone. So we were discussing basic types of signals, standard signals we were discussing till rectangular signal or rectangular signal, what is the other name? Gate pulse function, right? So we have seen up to gate pulse or rectangular pulse signal. Okay. A rect of T by tau, that was a mathematical representation, as well as a graphical representation also we have seen. Minus tau by 2 to plus tau by 2, amplitude is A. And its corresponding mathematical representation is A rect of T by tau, pulse width. Okay, next is triangular pulse function. It is going to be represented as mathematically A into 1 minus mod T by tau. This is a mathematical representation for triangular pulse function, standard representation. Now coming to graphical, if I want to plot it, this one as a graphical representation, at t equal to 0, substitute t as 0, because at t equal to 0 I am trying to find the amplitude. So to find the amplitude, use this expression, t equal to 0 you substitute, 1 minus 0 by tau is capital A. Let us say capital A is here. Here limits I didn't specify, sorry, please write the limits. Minus tau to tau, please understand the difference. Here limits were from minus tau by 2 to tau by 2. Whereas for triangular function, limits are from minus tau to tau. These are the standard representation. Depending on these ranges, we need to understand the labels here. Here minus tau to tau, but here tau is there. Okay. Total pulse width is tau, A rect of T by tau I have written there. Now minus tau to tau is there. At T equal to 0, I have substituted 1 into A, I got the amplitude. Now at T equal to minus tau, mod of minus tau is plus tau. 1 minus tau by tau, 1 minus 1 is 0. At t equal to plus tau, amplitude is 0. At t equal to minus tau also, amplitude is 0. Now join these points. This is the representation. So triangular pulse, whatever limits are there, as it is we have to write. Amplitude, whatever factor is there here, that is our amplitude. So this is about triangular function. Let us go for next type of standard representation signal. And the next one is signum function. Next type of signal is signum function. Its representation is signum of t. So signum of t amplitude is plus 1 for t greater than 0. And its amplitude is minus 1 for t less than 0. This is the mathematical representation of signum function. Now let us go for graphical representation. Signum of t plus 1 for t greater than 0, it's unit step. Minus 1 for t less than 0 means this side, minus 1 means third quadrant, straight line. It is a straight line, please draw it as a straight line. Even this duration should also be same, like minus 1 is here, minus 1. So this is a graphical representation of signum of t. Okay. Now next type of function, next standard type of signal is sync. Sync function. Okay. So in general, sync is going to be varied, S-I-N-C of theta. Its standard definition is sine pi theta by pi theta. This is the mathematical formula for sync function. Okay. Now, if I plot this sinc theta, because sinc t kind of function we never find, instead of direct t variable, n pi t, 2 t, like one more constants are going to be added. So, in general, we are studying this function, sinc function. Okay, if I plot this, it is going to be like this. Like this, okay, theta. So here amplitude is 1, 1 by pi, 2 by pi, minus 1 by pi, minus 2 by pi, 3 by pi, like that. Means these null points are going to be occurred at integer multiples of 1 by pi. Maximum one main loop will be there, side loops will be there. So as theta value going on increasing, these amplitude side loops are going to be completely eliminated, vanishes. One main loop and side loops. This is the properties of sinc function. Okay. One main loop will be there. Side loops will be there. And null points. These points where it is touching x-axis. Null points occur at integer multiples of 1 by pi, that is plus or minus n by pi. So this is about sync function. And the last one is Gaussian function. Last one is Gaussian function. So x of t equal to e power minus a t square. This is a mathematical representation of a Gaussian function. Next, graphical representation if I want to find. Suppose if I am not writing any limits for t, means by default it varies from minus infinite to infinite. Please understand that point. So here, minus infinite to infinite. Now at t equal to 0, what is the amplitude at t equal to 0? X of t value is e power minus a into 0, maximum amplitude 1 will be there. Okay. Next at t equal to plus infinite, 0. So somewhere at t equal to infinite, 0. Next at t equal to minus infinite whole square is plus infinite. Here also somewhere at bell shape. Gaussian function is a bell function, right? So this is a Gaussian function. Okay. So these are all the standard basic types of signals. We are going to perform all these perform operations on all these signals only. And also we are going to give all these signals as input to the system depending on our application and requirement. Okay. Thank you. Hi everyone. So we have completed standard type of signals. So first we started with a unit impulse, step, ramp, exponential, rectangular pulse, triangular, sync function, Gaussian, ramp. All these we have seen. Mathematical standard signals. Standard notation, you have to practice all those signals. Mathematical representation as well as graphical representation. Later on, directly we have unit step signal, means u of t equal to 1 for t greater than or equal to 0. Like that you have to remember and you have to draw the graph sheet. You have to draw the graph as well as you have to perform operations on those signals. Okay. Next one is basic operations on signals. So far we have completed classification, types of signals. Now operations on signals we are going to perform. So generally, what are the operations we can perform? Normal addition, multiplication, subtraction. These are the generalized operations, already well-known operations, all these. Amplitude, corresponding amplitudes we can add, we can subtract, we can multiply. Corresponding time instants amplitude. At t equal to 1, what is the first signal amplitude? What is the second signal amplitude? Those two we need to add. That is our resultant amplitude at t equal to 1. Like that, all these three we can perform. Apart from these normal operations, these are the special operations we can perform on signals. So folding operation, time folding, time shifting, scaling. Under scaling, two types are there. Time scaling as well as amplitude scaling. So let us come discuss all these one by one. First type of operation, put the heading. Time folding. First one is time folding, is there, na? So time folding or time reversal operation. Okay, for each one, we have to take one input signal, one example we have to take, perform that operation. So how to perform that operation, logic is important here. Okay, so for example, time reversal operation, take the standard signal. I am taking example as unit step signal. Okay, unit step signal, what is the definition? U of t equal to 1 for t greater than or equal to 0. 0 elsewhere. This is my condition. This is the definition of unit step. If I draw a graph, this is the representation u of t, t, right? U of t equal to 1 for t greater than or equal to 0. So after time reversal operation means t is minus t. Means wherever t is there, we have to replace with minus t. So this is also called as folding operation. In the standard definition, u of minus t. Here 1 is there. Constant I cannot modify. Suppose here t square is there. Minus t whole square I have to write. Suppose here t cube is there. Amplitude. Minus t whole cube I have to write. Means wherever t is there, I am replacing it with minus t. That is time reversal operation. Even in limits also, minus t greater than or equal to 0. 0 elsewhere. Elsewhere means what is the condition here? T less than 0. For minus t, less than 0. Now limits are minus t. But I am trying to plot U of minus t on y-axis. Always on x-axis I have to take with respect to t variable only. But limits are in terms of minus t. So how to get the limits in t? Change the equation. Okay. So this minus t greater than or equal to 0 means t is less than or equal to 0. Minus t is less than 0 means take t to this side. T greater than 0. So now u of minus t amplitude is 1. For t less than or equal to 0 means less than or equal to 0 means this side. For this particular limits, what is the amplitude? 1. Next, for t greater than 0 means exactly this side. What is the amplitude? 0. So this is it. So this is folding operation, flipping, flipper operation. First quadrant graph is shifted to second quadrant. Similarly, if ramp is there, R of t. This is my original input ramp. R of minus t, if I plot, it will transfer into second quadrant. So this is the operation. Logic here is t we have to replace with minus t. Even in limits also minus t we have to replace. But we need to plot the graph signal with respect to t variable. So get the limits in terms of t variable. So this is about time folding or time reversal operation. Next, shifting operation. Shifting, second type. Again, even in shifting also, left shifting, right shifting. Two types are there. Okay. So first, same. Take the same example. U of t. This is my U of t graph, right? One. What is its definition? U of t equal to 1 for t greater than or equal to 0. 0 for t less than 0. Else condition is t less than 0. Now, shifting means u of t is going to be shifted by some factor, minus 2. So, 2 times minus 2 I have added here. T is replaced with t minus t. Now, here t I have replaced with t minus 2, right? So, take this definition here. Now, I am trying to sketch this shifted signal. U of t is shifted by 2 times. Let us see whether it is right shifting or left shifting. Okay. U of t minus 2. Here 1 is there. 1 I cannot modify. Constant. Here t is there. T I have replaced with t minus 2. Greater than or equal to 0. Now what are the limits of t? T is greater than or equal to 2. Now here 0 I cannot modify. T is there. I have to replace with t minus 2. Less than 0. Now get the limits for t. Okay. Now u of t minus 2, I would like to draw the signal u of t minus 2 on x-axis with respect to t. For t greater than or equal to 2, what is its amplitude? 1. Here 0, 1, 2. So starting limit is 2. Its amplitude is like this. Now for t less than 2, means beyond this range, its amplitude is 0. Now observe these two. Original u of t is this. U of t minus 2 is this. What is the change you can observe? U of t is right shifted by how many times? 2 times. Remember this point. U of t is right shifted by 2 times. Okay. Now let us plot u of t plus t. So, for to draw the signal u of t plus 2, again we have to depend on the standard definition only. In the standard definition, wherever t is there, I am replacing it with t plus 2. So, u of t plus 2, I would like to draw. U of t plus 2 from the definition, its amplitude is 1 for t plus 2 greater than or equal to 0. And it is 0 for t plus 2 less than 0. Now, get the limits in terms of t variable. U of t plus 2 equal to 1 for t greater than or equal to minus 2. 0 for t less than minus 2. So u of t plus 2 amplitude values I am having. Corresponding time values I am having. Now draw the graph. u of t plus 2. Now t greater than or equal to minus 2 is there. 0, minus 1, minus 2, okay, minus 3, so on. So on variables will be there. Greater than or equal to minus 2, what is the amplitude? 1. For less than minus 2, it is 0. Now observe, u of t is this, u of t plus 2 is this, u of t is left shifted by 2 times. So these 2 points you need to understand here. So u of t minus 2 means u of t is right shifted by 2. U of t plus 2 means u of t is left shifted by 2. Next, 2 more cases will be there. What are those cases? U of minus t plus 2, u of minus t minus 2. Same thing we can perform. Like if we suppose here minus t plus 2 is there, means here minus t plus 2 I have to write. Like that I have to draw the graphs. So here one shortcut is there. Just remember that, make a note. Make a note. If x of t is continuous time signal, then x of t plus k, x of minus t minus k, x of t minus k, x of minus t plus k. So here both the signs are same, means x of t is going to be left shifted by k times. Just now we have seen u of t plus 2 means u of t is left shifted by k times. Left means left side negative will be there 2 times. X of minus t, same signs are there. Remember this. So here x of minus t is going to be left shifted by k times. X of minus t, u of minus t, how it will be? This is u of minus t. Left shifting and then again it will be like this. Okay. Now x of t minus k, opposite signs. One is positive sign, one negative sign. Right shifting. X of t is going to be right shifted by k. Similarly here, different changes. One negative, one positive. So right shifting. Which is going to be right shifted? T. Check the t sign. T is negative here. So x of minus t is going to be right shifted by k times. So this is about basically time shifting operations. Left shifting, right shifting. Left shifting or right shifting means depending on these two variables. Positive sign is there or negative sign is there. Both the signs are same means left shifting. Opposite signs are there means right shifting. So whether x of t is right shifted or x of minus t is right shifted, that is by seeing the symbol, I mean that plus or minus of t variable. If t is positive means x of t is going to be shifted. If t is negative means x of minus t is going to be shifted. Okay?